Are you tired of the hustle and bustle of the city? Today I'm going to give you a tour of a really cool rural neighborhood outside of Seattle. It's about a 30-minute drive without traffic. Stay tuned right after this. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Karen Jackson. I'm a residential real estate agent with John L. Scott in King County, Washington. I've been helping buyers and sellers since 2004. Thank you so much for watching. If you've not yet subscribed to my channel, please go and do that right away. I don't want you to miss out on any of my videos. I put them out every Wednesday. The Green Valley River Valley area in Auburn, Washington is a rural community that is found off of the Auburn Black Diamond exit of Highway 18, and it is along the Southeast Green Valley Road. It is in East Auburn, which is close to Black Diamond, Washington. The road runs along the Green River. There are many landmarks to share with you along this road. It is bustling with all sorts of different activities and wildlife. The road starts off with Neely Mansion. Neely Mansion is a historic Victorian farmhouse that was built in 1894. The Neely Farm consists of 284 acres, which originally was operated as a dairy, potatoes and other crops, and an orchard with apple, pear, and cherry trees. It has since been restored for the public. They do tours in the summer on Saturdays usually, and they do some events throughout the year. There's usually a tea on Mother's Day weekend and the first weekend in December. You can find the website for Neely Mansion above. Just past the mansion on the left, there is a boat launch to the river for smaller river boats. Many people hang out here when it is hot out. There's a large raised gravel area in the middle of the river, so it is easy to lounge. On the right is Green Valley Meats. They have delicious beef jerky and pepperoni, steaks, and all sorts of meats, and some emergent groceries. They have milk, eggs, beer and wine, and some other necessities. You should check them out. It is a great place to get your items for a barbecue. On the left is Mosby Farms. I am sure you have heard their advertisements. It is a large vegetable growing farm. There are many land plots along Green Valley Road of zucchini, leeks, rhubarb, corn, and pumpkins. And there's probably others that I'm just not aware of. Mosby's also has a pumpkin patch in the fall and a corn maze. You will see lots of livestock along this road, horses, cows, pigs, llamas, chickens, turkeys, raccoons, deer, and there's a large herd of elk that hangs out in some of the fields. Many of the residents on this road have lived here for generations. Many of the homes have been around since the 1800s.
Some residents are living in their great-grandparents' homes. Most homes in the Valley in 2020 range from $500,000 to over $2 million. As you can see, there are some very small homes and some very large homes. Most are on 12-acre or larger parcels, but there are a few smaller lots that were adjusted years ago. I have attached a link in the comments to show all the current housing listings for the area. The Green Valley area is served by the Auburn School District.
Make sure you keep watching. There's lots of cool stuff down the road.
Motorcycles and bicycle riders love this road because it is a beautiful drive and windy, and not so much traffic, although there is a lot more traffic on it these days than there used to be. On the right is Coates Christmas Tree Farm. They sell U-cut Christmas trees starting in November. On the left is Canterbury Farms. This farm was homesteaded in 1870s and has been family owned since 1954. It is a beautiful farm with lots of beautiful flowers to look at. They have acres of blueberries and a U-Pick farm that opens in July. They also sell really yummy blueberry wine year round. They also raise and train saddlebred horses. On the left is Green Valley's Honey Tree Farm. This is another U-cut Christmas tree farm. In the summer, there are a lot of people that float the river. Flaming Geyser Park and Whitney Bridge are popular pickup and drop-off spots. On the right, you will find Argus Ranch Dog Sports and Training Center. They have lots of dog classes and trainings and agility events. There's something going on every week there. If you go a bit further, you will run into Flaming Geyser Park. It is a day-use park. It is centered around a flaming geyser, which is a cluster of once-active methane seeps. It no longer seeps because the methane source has been depleted. The park has four group picnic sites that hold 50 people, so many people hold barbecues or parties here. Many rafters and kayakers and fishermen enjoy the river, and there are some hiking trails as well. There is also a dedicated field area set aside for radio-controlled aircraft activities. It's pretty cool to watch. You should go check it out. If you continue to the end of Green Valley Road, it will take you to Highway 169. If you go right, you will go to Black Diamond and then to Enumclaw. If you go left, it will take you to Maple Valley and Renton. Thank you for visiting. If you have any questions about the area, or if you would like to learn more about a different area in Washington, then leave a comment below. I'd be happy to help you.